Hello everyone, welcome to Grow Med. This channel is a one-stop guide for all the FMG aspirants. You can find here everything you need for the exam, mnemonics, then previous year questions, important topics. So if you're new to Grow Med, subscribe to Grow Med and tap the bell icon. In this video, we will be discussing about the drugs which are used in the ophthalmology. So we will be discussing everything, the drugs, the condition for which it is used and along with that the mechanism of action. उसके साथ साथ हम ये भी डिस्कस करेंगे कि इसके साइड इफेक्ट्स क्या होते हैं और अगर साइड इफेक्ट्स हुआ भी तो हम क्या करेंगे. ओके, ऑल दोज थिंग्स एंड दीज थिंग्स आर फ्रीक्वेंटली आस्क्ड इन द एफएमजी. तो ग्लॉकोमा के जो ड्रग्स हैं ना, एंटी ग्लॉकोमा ड्रग्स, इस पर क्वेश्चंस फ्रीक्वेंटली पूछे गए हैं एफएमजी पे. ओके, देन द साइक्लोपिजिक्स, देन एंटी वीईजीएफ ड्रग्स, देन देर आर वेरियस अदर कंडीशंस फॉर विच देर आर सर्टन ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस. तो हम उसको भी सब चीज़ यहाँ पर देखेंगे. तो इट विल बी लाइक सारी चीज़ें एक ही जगह पर डिस्कस हो जाएंगी. सो इट विल हेल्प यू ऑल इन योर लास्ट मिनट रिविजन. सो इट विल बी अ टू पेज thing and all the questions PYQs all are included in it. So all you need to do is just watch the video and read the notes and revise this PDF. okay, and for the PDF you can join my Telegram channel. I will be sharing this PDF there, and also follow me on Instagram for more amazing videos related to the FMG. Let's start the video. So the anti-glaucoma drugs, these are asked in integration with the pharmacology also. So glaucoma mein usually kya hota hai ki the thing is there will be raised intraocular pressure. So our main motive of the treatment is to reduce the intraocular pressure, and we will do it by using two main modalities, methods. First one is to decrease the production of the aqueous humor, or else the other treatment option is to increase the outflow of the aqueous humor. So the drugs which help in decrease of the production are the alpha agonist, alpha 2 agonist, and the beta blocker. Okay, so the examples of the drug are praclonidine, apraclonidine, and brimonidine. So these two act by stimulating the alpha 2 receptor and help in decreasing the production, whereas the beta blocker, it is the timolol. We already know that the drugs ending with the lol, these are the beta blockers, and which is a very good mnemonic to remember which of the following drugs are the beta blockers. Okay, so timolol, it is a beta blocker. So questions are asked on its side effect. The alpraclonidine, its side effect is that it causes lid retraction, and the side effect of the brimonidine is it causes brain suppression, so due to which it is contraindicated in the depression. तो ये ब्रेन डिप्रेशन कॉज कर रहा है ना, तो ड्यू टू ब्रेन डिप्रेशन देर विल बी ऑल्सो सप्रेशन, देर विल बी सप्रेशन ऑफ अनदर सेंटर, दैट इज़ द रेस्पिरेटरी सेंटर. तो रेस्पिरेटरी सप्रेशन भी हो जाती है ब्रिमोनिडिन के वजह से. ओके, सो दिस इज ऑल्सो एन इंपॉर्टेंट साइड इफेक्ट सीन विद द ब्रोमोनिडिन. देन मूविंग ऑन टू द टीमोलोल. सो दिस टीमोलोल फेमस क्वेश्चन, दिस वन इज अ वेरी फेमस क्वेश्चन. तो क्लिनिकल केस बेस में पूछा गया है दिस क्वेश्चन, वन लाइनर के फॉर्म में पूछा गया है. ओके, तो वन लाइनर मीन्स सिंपली विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज द साइड इफेक्ट ऑफ द टीमोलोल, और अनदर वेरियंट इज टीमोलोल इज कॉन्ट्राइंडिकेटेड इन विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग. तो इट इज कॉन्ट्राइंडिकेटेड इन द अस्थमेटिक पेशेंट. ओके, तो हम इसको कैसे समझेंगे कि अस्थमा है, तो अस्थमा में ब्रोंको कंस्ट्रिक्शन हुआ रहता है, और हम ऊपर से बीटा ब्लॉकर और देंगे और फिर ये और ज़्यादा ब्रोंको कंस्ट्रिक्शन कॉज करेगा. ठीक है, तो इसीलिए वी विल बी अवॉइडिंग दिस वन इन द अस्थमेटिक्स. तो अभी हम देख लेते हैं कि अगर क्लिनिकल केस पूछा गया है तो क्या क्या चीज़ें डिस्क्राइब की रहेगी क्वेश्चन में. तो क्लिनिकल केस में यूजुअली ऐसा रहता है कि वन फीमेल वॉज देयर एंड शी वॉज हैविंग ग्लॉकोमा. तो ग्लॉकोमा के लिए वी हैड प्रिस्क्राइब्ड अ बीटा ब्लॉकर, दैट इज टीमोलोल. सो नाउ शी प्रेजेंट्स विद कफ, शॉर्टनेस ऑफ ब्रेथ. So what will be the cause? So it will be because of timolol, which is a beta blocker. Or dusra variant hai ki there was a female, she was having asthma, theek hai, asthma bhi tha usko, and now presents to you with the glaucoma. So which of the following drug will you, so it will be timolol, which we will be avoiding. Theek hai, so this one is a PYQ, you must remember it. So ye ho gaya beta blocker and drugs that decrease the production. Now we will speak about the drugs which increase the outflow. So there are two methods for this also. First one is by increasing the trabecular outflow, and second one by increasing the uveoscleral outflow. So the drugs that act by increasing the trabecular outflow, these are mainly the mitotics, and the example pilocarpine and the physostigmine. Okay, so ye dono kya hai, these are the cholinergic drugs. तो दीज एक्ट, दिस पिलोकार्पिन डायरेक्टली एक्ट्स ऑन द रिसेप्टर, एंड दिस फाइजोस्टिग्मिन इट एक्ट्स बाय इंक्रीजिंग द ACH. ओके, सो दीज आर द कोलिनर्जिक ड्रग्स, एंड द साइड इफेक्ट एसोसिएटेड विद दीज इज दैट दे विल बी कॉजिंग कैटरैक्ट एंड नेसोलैक्रिमल डक्ट स्टेनोसिस. So the NLD stands for the nasolacrimal duct stenosis. Okay. Then moving on to the increase in the uveoscleral outflow, and this one is done by important drug, which is the latanoprost. So mechanism of action is that it is a prostaglandin F2 agonist. Okay, so it is a prostaglandin agonist, and it is the drug of choice for this glaucoma, for the open angle glaucoma. Open angle glaucoma ke liye ye drug of choice hai, and this is also a PYQ asked multiple time. Theek hai, to latanoprost is also a very famous question for the FMG. फ्रीक्वेंटली इस लैटनोप्रास्ट पे भी क्वेश्चन पूछे गए हैं, एंड क्वेश्चन आर आस्क्ड ऑन इट्स साइड इफेक्ट. तो इसके भी बहुत सीरियस साइड इफेक्ट्स है, लाइक हेट्रोक्रोमिया आयराइटिस, मीन्स इट विल कॉज पिगमेंटेशन. हेट्रो मीन्स चेंज इन द कलर. ओके, सो इट विल कॉज द पिगमेंटेशन ऑफ द आईरिस. देन हाइपर ट्राइकोसिस, इट इंक्रीज द ग्रोथ ऑफ द आई लैशेज. ठीक है, तो विच इज कॉल्ड एज द हाइपर ट्राइकोसिस, एंड इट ऑल्सो कॉजेज मैक्युलर एडिमा. सो दीज थ्री आर द साइड इफेक्ट्स ऑफ द लैटनोप्रास्ट. So these were the important drugs which you must remember from the glaucoma. And also there's another drug that will decrease the production, which is the carbonic anhydrase inhibitor. So the example of this carbonic anhydrase inhibitors are the acetazolamide, drozolamide, and brinzolamide. Okay, so these are also used to treat the glaucoma, especially the angle closure glaucoma. So this is the list of the drugs used in the glaucoma. Now let's discuss some important one-liners and the other points regarding these questions. So question, this all are the PYQs. Okay, so drug of choice in children for glaucoma, and it is the drozolamide. Drozolamide is safest in children, so it is used as a drug of choice, and it is also a carbonic anhydrase inhibitor, as we have discussed here. Okay, then drug of choice for acute angle closure glaucoma, it is the mannitol, and drug of choice for open angle glaucoma is the latanoprost. And also questions are asked on the most powerful drug for the glaucoma, which is the latanoprost. Then one-liners are asked on the fastest acting drug, which is the mannitol and the acetazolamide. So this was the things from the glaucoma and the glaucoma drugs which you must remember. Then moving on to the next category of the drugs, which is cycloplegics. So these are cycloplegic as well as mydriatic. Mydriatic means dilation of the pupil, and cycloplegic means paralysis of muscles of accommodation, and this is done to do the test of the refractive error. So these cycloplegics, these are the anti-muscarine drugs, anticholinergic drugs, and they will be acting by blocking the muscarinic block receptors. So let's look at the examples of these drugs: atropine, homatropine, cyclopentolate, and tropicamide. So these are the drugs which are called as the cycloplegic, and questions are asked on its effect, duration of the effect. Like the atropine, it acts for 7 to 10 days, and it is the strongest drug. So it is preferred in the children because of its strongest effect and its long lasting effect, because in children the movement of the muscle will be very fast, so the muscle will be very active, and there will be active accommodation happening in the children. So we need to use some stronger drug, and the drug used in children is the atropine. Then homatropine, 1 to 3 days, cyclopentolate 1 day, and tropicamide 6 hours. So shortest acting, weakest, shortest acting, so it is preferred in adults, because in adults, as the age increases, the muscles also start to weaken, and if we use a strong drug like atropine, then there will be accommodation, loss of accommodation for 7 to 10 days, which will be very problematic. So in children, in adult, we will be using the weakest cycloplegic, that is the tropicamide. Clinical case kind of questions are asked on this cycloplegic, like they'll be describing that children or adult, they have come for refractive error, test of the refractive error, and which of the following drugs you will be using. So based on the group described, either it is children or adult, you need to choose it. Okay, then moving on, there's another important PYQ and a one-liner, which is shortest acting mydriatic without cycloplegia, and the answer is the phenylephrine. So phenylephrine, it is a mydriatic drug, but it does not cause cycloplegia. So this was all about the cycloplegic. Then moving on, anti-VEGF drugs. So these are also an important class of drugs used in ophthalmology. And these drugs are used in various conditions like non-proliferative diabetic retinopathy, then CRVO, central retinal venous occlusion, branched retinal venous occlusion, and age-related macular degeneration. So the mechanism of action of this drug is it will be blocking the VEGF, which is the vascular endothelial growth factor. So by blocking this factor, no new blood vessel formation will be occurring. And we need this mainly for the diabetic retinopathy, because in this, there will be formation of the new blood vessels. And likewise in the branched and the central retinal vein occlusion. This property will be needed that we do not want the proliferation and the formation of the new blood vessels. So in these conditions, we will be using this anti-VEGF drugs. So the examples are the bevacizumab and the ranisumab. So this one is also a PYQ. This bevacizumab questions have been asked multiple times. So केस डिस्क्राइब कर देंगे एक कि एक डायबिटिक पेशेंट है और ही कम्स फॉर द एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ द आई एंड यू सी दैट देयर इज प्रोलिफरेशन ऑफ द न्यू ब्लड वेसल्स एंड सो इन दोज कंडीशंस वी विल बी यूजिंग द बिवासिजुमैब. ओके देन ऑल्सो क्वेश्चन आर आस्क्ड ऑन कि बिवासिजुमैब की मैकेनिज्म ऑफ एक्शन क्या है, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज द एंटी वीईजीएफ ड्रग. ओके सो क्वेश्चन हैव बीन आस्क्ड मल्टीपल टाइम्स. देन मूविंग ऑन, लेट्स डिस्कस सम इंपॉर्टेंट ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस for various conditions. Like for viral keratitis, the drug of choice is the acyclovir, and for CMV retinitis, it is the ganciclovir. So PYQ, and these both are the antiviral drugs. Okay, then for orbital cellulitis, it is IV vancomycin and oral clindamycin. So as it is an infectious condition and the infectious is mostly caused by the staph aureus, so we will be using these antimicrobials, antibiotics to treat this condition. Then this is also a very important PYQ, that for trachoma, which of the following drug we will be using, and it is the azithromycin. So azithromycin is the first line drug for trachoma. Iske alawa hum dusre drugs bhi use kar sakte hai, jaise ki doxycycline, fir tetracycline bhi use kar sakte hai hum. And questions are also asked ki dosage pe ki kitna dose denge hum. To azithromycin ka bas 1 mg dose and 1 dose, one dose, only single dose treatment of the azithromycin is required for the trachoma. Then moving on, erythromycin ointment, it is used for the ophthalmia neonatorum. Then for acanthamoeba keratitis, we will be using PHMB. So this one is also a PYQ, and another drug is the chlorhexidine. So if at all they want to ask about the acanthamoeba like a case, then dekh lena question mein to contact lens wear rahega hi rahega, because contact lens wear and acanthamoeba keratitis, famous question and a favorite question of the FMG. And fir agar treatment pooch liya, then you will be giving PHMB. Okay. Then for fungal keratitis, amphotericin B. Then mitomycin C for recurrent terium. So this one is also a PYQ. And bas terium puchenge, to it will be the excision. Okay. But if they are asking about the recurrent, then mitomycin C. To avoid the recurrence or for the prevention of the recurrence, mitomycin C. Then moving on to steroids. Steroids, this group of drugs is used for a lot of conditions like uveitis, all kind of the uveitis, the anterior, then the pan uveitis, इंटरमीडिएट यूवीआईटिस. तो सारी यूवीआईटिस के लिए हम स्टीरॉइड्स यूज़ करते हैं. तो किसी किसी में टॉपिकल स्टीरॉइड्स यूज़ करते हैं, किसी किसी में सिस्टमिक स्टीरॉइड्स. ओके देन थायरॉयड आई डिसीज, डायबिटिक रेटिनोपैथी, केराटोकंजंक्टिवाइटिस सिका. देन वेरियस अदर इन्फेक्शियस कंडीशन में भी हम यूज़ कर सकते हैं, लाइक केराटाइटिस. केराटाइटिस में भी वी कैन यूज़ इट. So steroids, the thing which you must remember from the steroids is the side effect. So these both are the previous year questions. So तो अगर स्टीरॉइड्स ओरल लेंगे देन इट विल कॉज कैटरैक्ट, एंड इफ़ वी टेक टॉपिकल स्टीरॉइड्स देन इट विल कॉज ग्लाउकोमा. सो डू रिमेंबर दिस थिंग, दिस थिंग इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. देन पाइरिडोस्टिगमिन, इट इज़ यूज्ड फॉर द मायस्थीनिया ग्रेविस. सो दिस वन इज़ द कोलिनर्जिक ड्रग एंड इट विल एक्ट बाई इंक्रीजिंग द एसिटाइल कोलिन. एंड मायस्थीनिया ग्रेविस इज ऑल्सो अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक. फ्रीक्वेंटली क्वेश्चन आर आस्क्ड ऑन दिस, मतलब यू कैन एक्सपेक्ट वन क्वेश्चन in the July exam also from this. Question can be asked on its treatment or make the diagnosis or all of the following are correct except kind of a question. So do look at all the points from the myasthenia gravis. So this was a quick review of the drugs which are used in the ophthalmology. So along with the drugs, we have also discussed about the previous year questions. Hope this video will help you all in your revision. Thank you so much for watching this video. Share the video with your friends, and if you are new to GrowMed, subscribe to GrowMed. Thank you so much. Bye bye.